All right, we're now joined, as you heard recently, the Minister of Health, Dr. the Honourable Christopher Tufton, warned taxi drivers across Jamaica that the government may confiscate their licences if they continue to bar nurses from accessing their services due to the fear of COVID-19. I suggested, I'm not certain if he could do that, but join us now via the telephone to give us an update on the issues. The President of the Nurses Association of Jamaica, Carmen Johnson. Morning, Madam President.
Good morning, Neblan. Good morning, Empress, and to your listeners. How are you?
Very well.
Great. Thank you so much. How are you doing?
I am doing well.
And let me just say, we thank you and your group so much for what you guys been doing. Can't do this without you. And I know it's serious times and dangerous for your nurses and for yourself and their families, but they're on the front line, and we thank you for that. So please let your nurses know that we really appreciate what they're doing. Before we go to the taxi thing, we would have heard, and people are wondering if the nurses are protected. I remember speaking to someone who was quarantined, and she had a concern about the nurses who were at the place where she was quarantined because she didn't think that they were protected. What's going on with equipment to protect the nurses and doctors? Well, let's speak for the nurses. You can't speak for the doctors. Hello?
Yes, I'm hearing you. Just want to say, enough respect to our nurses and our healthcare workers who are at the forefront of the very unknown and who are seeking to stand firm and to do what they have got to do in this battle. Mm-hmm. We are in a better place than when we had just started with protective gear. And so our nurses and our employees are better able to protect themselves at present.
In this case, protective gear means what? I know you have like, the
so
mask.
So our protective gear includes wearing the mask, the head cover, the gown, or the coverall. It also means your overshoes and your gloves.
And that is what is required?
Yes, that's what's required.
So we are okay with that, with all the nurses who are involved here?
Well, I wouldn't say all the nurses, but those who are really treating with the corona cases, they have what they need now. What we will continue to do is to monitor, but as I've said to them, use what you have now. When you don't have it, then we will treat with that. So we are in a better place than when we had just had started or just hearing about the corona.
Excellent. Let me ask you, President Johnson, regarding the taxi operators and their refusal to carry the nurses, what can be done here? What's the solution?
What I recognized on Monday, listening to the president of Jackson, was that it is still the fear of the unknown, the anxiety, the concern over about what is happening, not knowing what to do. And it is not anything strange for the taxi drivers. It is happening to us also because, as you are aware, it's a new virus. Nobody understands how it really works, what it really does. Mm-hmm. We all have family, we all have our colleagues, we all have those who we must care for. And so they were concerned. What was their concern instead was that they were not educated in a wholesome manner as to what it is, what to expect, how to protect themselves, and what to do. Since then, we have had dialogue with the Ministry of Health Public Relations Department, who have made contact with them to see how they can get that sector of the society to better understand what is happening. And so I think with further education, they should be doing better because it is a really unfortunate situation that really just puts our nurses in a mindset that really just the fear that they already have themselves, the concerns that they have themselves just trigger them into a different zone. And so it is very unfortunate that for those things to be happening in the parishes that it has taken place. What I do know is that some parishes, they are doing a little better now, while some you still have it. But as we go along, we're hoping that as the knowledge unfolds and they are educated more and the persons are going out on the streets to educate them, that they'll be doing differently.
Excellent. Nurse, I have to ask you about our immune system and other healthy practices, not just the hand washing, but the foods that we eat. If we were to be infected, how do we build up our immune system? How do we stay healthy with the foods we eat or the medication that we should have stocked up in our cupboards? Help us with that information, please.
All right, so what we need to do is to start build our immune system before we are affected. But if we get affected before we do, what we need to do is to ensure that the first thing is that to ensure that you are properly hydrated. We are drinking enough water.
Mm-hmm.
Make sure you are hydrating yourself so that if you have a fever, it doesn't get dry out, it doesn't get too sick, because the fever will dry out and make you weak, make you more susceptible to all that is happening to you. So first, start drinking enough water. Exercise is very important to build your stamina. And so you may be not be able to run or go to a gym, but you can walk around the yard, you can sweep up the place, you can do some jumping jacks, you can do a little skipping. Do that. And what we'll say is eat more foods that grow on trees and grow in the garden than those that are made in the factories.
Mm.
So eat what is natural. Make your juices. You can find an orange, you have an orange, a grapefruit, whatever kind of fruit you can find, you put them together and have them. You can have your, you must have your vegetables. And green juices are very good for the system to cleanse it and to purify it and to strengthen it. So you can blend your vegetables and you can have them. Have them fresh better. Don't blend and keep for long days, but blend and drink as you can. So you're going to eat your fruits and your vegetables. You're going to eat your carbohydrates and your protein. Ensure you're having as close to a balanced diet as you can afford. So the fresher the food, the better for us. The food that grows on the trees and in the gardens or in the farm, it is better than those that are processed and are soaked in brine and other things. The fresher the food is prepared, again, the better than you are eating. The fast food that are in oil have the fats that are not good for your system, then you are able to fight and to be stronger and to be better. And what we say, keep some vitamin C on hand. Vitamin
Excellent.
C does help to boost the immunity. But if you can't try the tablets, have your food and vegetables.
All right.
Thank you.
President Carmen, I want to go back to the taxi drivers. The minister said a couple of days ago that 5 buses would be dedicated to transporting nurses to and from work. Has that been put in place yet?
If that is?
Has that been put in place?
The buses, let me tell you, the genesis of the buses is that that was a part of our negotiation that we have had ongoing.
Mm-hmm.
And last year we took a stand that we must have the buses now. And so the buses were purchased. They were owned and they were being branded. And so we have the buses. What we have said to the minister since Saturday is that those buses that we have that should be handed over, can we now have them in the system, have drivers ready to drive them, so that for nurses in the Cape Town and Catherine region where those buses would be, that can we now have them where it can take the nurses and possibly the healthcare workers who are traveling along the same route to work now rather than waiting until the prices get deepened. So we are hoping that before the end of this week, that those buses will be operational, where the persons will have greater access to that service within the Cape Town and the St. Catherine region.
Yep. Why?
And so I have no doubt that they'll be in.
Why that region, and how many buses would be ideal?
The challenge with it is that when we had asked for buses for the Cape Town region because of the violence within that region,
okay,
and the difficulty that our colleagues were having.
Okay.
We had also asked of at least one bus per parish. What we were told then when we were asking for this was that they do not have the resources to purchase the buses. When we look at Montego Bay and other areas that were having a challenge, we say, can we at least have 6 coastal buses? We were told that they couldn't give us more than 2, but we continued the negotiation until we reached where we were able to get 4 coastal buses.
Okay.
And so we have those 4 coastal buses for the Cape Town and St. Catherine region. The other one is a small Toyota bus for the NAJ to go around that we are seeking to say, once you have a driver, we will also be using it to assist with transportation of our nurses.
All right.
Our hope is that this will bring to the front our need, where we've been asking to say, can we at least ensure that we have at least one bus per parish to assist our colleagues while they travel to and from, especially during the later hours of the night, coming off at 10, 11 o'clock, going on at 10, somewhere around 11 o'clock, region, you're reaching work. And so that's why it is only that number of buses.
All right. Thanks a lot for speaking with us. And again, please tell your nurses that we appreciate them. And
yes, and big up to our nurses and to our other healthcare workers. And
right,
we appreciate them, continue to protect themselves, do what they have got to do, because we too will survive this in the long run. We have survived before and we'll continue to survive.
Yeah, hold on, nurse. I know Neville was saying goodbye, but something just came to my mind.
Okay.
What do you know about the Cuban healthcare workers who are coming in? Have they arrived?
No, they have not yet arrived.
Okay. And are you looking forward to that collaboration?
We are looking forward to it, and we hope they'll prove useful.
Excellent.
All right. Thanks a lot, Carmine Johnson.
You're president welcome. Have a very good holiday.
You too.
Well, Carmine Johnson, president of the Nurses Association of Jamaica.
Still to come, my people, coping with the stress and anxiety of COVID-19 and being financially prepared for a health crisis. Well, we'll be right back. And while you listen to the commercial break, wash your hands and stay sanitized.